Hi guys, welcome back with me, ChaoChao 2025. We're going to learn how to make a picture in Stable Diffusion using certain picture that have a face and put it on the generation. So you could add any faces that you want without doing training or Lora and stuff using Roop for Stable Diffusion. First of all, you need to have automatic 1111. You could check my older video. And then Roop. But before we install Roop, we need to have Visual Studio here. I'll put these two links in the description. And after that, you could do the free download. After you download it, you open it, the installer, and this thing will show up. I already have this, but you could just click modify here. This is what you need. You need Python development and C++. That's what you need, okay? Python and C++. You could add others if you want, like other stuff, but we're not going to use that. After you click that, you simply install while downloading. I already downloaded it, so I don't need to use it anymore. After that, you need to run this command, pip install insightface. So just simply open CMD and install this. Okay, it's finished. The process is not that long. Okay, how to get that? Just simply open our Stable Diffusion installation extension and install from your available here. Just search for Roop. Enable fast swapping with reference image. Yeah, that's true for you. Just click install. Okay, after you install it, it's gonna look like this. Install soft Stable Diffusion. Use install tab to restart. Okay, let's get to install here. We should already have Roop here. So just apply and restart UI. Okay, just be patient when you restart. Okay, it's downloaded a lot of things, Roop that is. So yeah, when it restarts, it downloaded a lot of things and many is big files, and this time it's going to be fast because it's not installing anything. But Roop going to be showing up. There is Roop below here, so yeah. Let's make a random prompt where man wearing a suit, office, sitting. Yeah, maybe like this. Let's create a picture first so we know the comparison. Okay. Here is the picture. We're going to remember the seat, so it's going to be this seat. And we're going to add picture now. Click Roop, and you have this picture. Let's try instant face. Just drop it here. Make sure you click enable here. This is comma separated, so just ignore this if you have one people in this place. And upscaler and install visibility. It's just the same. Let's generate now. If you are doing this for the first time, it's going to take some time because it's going to download the models and stuff. But if this is your like second time or stuff, don't worry. And we have only one model here. Okay, this looks like instant, right? And the picture is the same actually. Now we could use our example. For example, we have this random guy I generate using Stable Diffusion. And let's generate. See, it's the same. The hair not changing, only the face, because this is face swap, okay? But maybe you don't know this guy, so we're going to add people that you might know, like this guy. And let's see. Yeah, said Hitler, all right. That's fast sport for you. And it's also actually could work for woman. So let's add a new prop. Woman in the garden wearing sportwear. Upper body. Let's put this so it's not generated. Crazy image. Let's just randomize the seat again and see if something could come up. Okay, it's Asian. guess we could work it out. Okay, remember the seed here. And now let's add another picture. First, we got this UL girl. See, it's uncanny, man, the difference is. And you don't need to use even any Lora training, so that's really crazy. Let's use another picture. And let's generate. She's not Asian, so it might ruin the image, but I don't know. It's actually worked well. It's still the same. The face is not as big as the torch, but it's still her. And maybe this picture is lost, so put it here. And yeah, this is her. All right. Okay, now we're going to do something else. We're going to generate two girls, or two men, that is. Okay, this time we're going to generate two people in one picture, just so we could know what to do with them. Okay, this is two people, right, in one picture. Let's save the seed. It's not really a great picture, but you could always generate one picture, a great picture later. I'm just gonna give you an example. Now, if you want to change one of them, you could do this, like, put it here. Remember to enable it. Zero mean you're gonna use the zero or the first face. Then if you give comma one, you're gonna change these faces also. So zero and one, it's gonna change both of their faces. We already use the same seed, so it's gonna generate the same image, but with a different face. Okay, now both is Stalin, right? But if we only want to change like the first guy here, simply use zero only, and it's gonna change the first picture from left to right. Yeah, this guy face gonna change. And if you want to change the other guy face, just write one here, because so this is zero, this is one. Let's generate it. No, this guy is the Stalin. How if we want to use this guy face using another face? So two people to swap. Okay, the first way we could use in painting, just send it to in painting that we want to use. Just use it like a regular in painting, and it also has Roop. So this time we're going to add another picture that is Hitler. Oh, I forgot, you need to enable the Roop first. That's why the face is not changing. Okay, now it's Hitler and Stalin. Okay, this is the first way, and you know, it's gonna take two steps. There's actually another way that I got from my friend. First, you need to access your Stable Diffusion web UI, and then extension. Where's the extension? And just copy paste the root folder here and name it Roop 2, and then simply restart this. Let's reload the UI. Let's get back the setting like before. Okay, now I already set up this like before. Now we have two Roop, and Roop 1 and Roop 2. Now we can generate two faces. So for example, going to first using instant face. Actually, enable this at zero, and then second Roop, we could use other faces like this guy faces and put it one, and make sure you enable this too. Of course, it's gonna take more time to load because it's two models, but it's not going to be that bad. Process start and 95% here, so it's process swapping after it's done 95%. See? It's changing, right? Let's try this other face. You could put the main face, a girl face in the main. It works. Yes, it works. Of course, it looks strange because yeah, it's a girl face in a man body. But it works, guys. It's way better than manually using Lora. And after that, if you don't feel satisfied, you could just edit it in painting. And okay, one more time. This time, the woman. Okay, this time it's very tricky because there's more than two women here. There's a lot of people actually. We could use this to count like 0, 1, 2, 3. So let's add 1, 2, 3 to the face. Okay, enable it. Enable it. Make sure you choose this. 0, 1, 2, it's 2. And this one is 3. Or this thing not count. We'll see if this thing is count or not. Okay, this is actually the. So this girl is not count. I guess it's 0, 1, 2, and 3. So let's change it to 1 and 2. This is not considered a face. So that's a trick, you know. Of course, using two Roop, it's gonna take a toll on your GPU. Okay, it's done. It works like wonder. Okay, let's try other faces. Remember her? Yeah. That's great, right, guys? Okay, guys, this is the final result from this base models. Using instant face, using this guy face, using Hitler face. And this is using Alba face, using Moro face, using Driscoll face. You know, it's all changing. And it's really look like the original. And this is the original face. This is only one face. This is second face. This is both face changing. And this is also the same. Yeah, that's that guy. It's really helpful, this thing is. And without Lora training, that is, it's crazy, man. This model is crazy capable. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, share, and comment. And see you again on the next episode. Have a nice day.